Glasgow has a special relationship with coal. The local 18th century inventor of a coal-powered steam engine is memorialised in the city's square.
It's not known, but Glasgow's a real sort of fossil capital.
Visitors in town for the COP26 summit step back in time to reflect on the city's connection with the current climate challenge.
We're going to try and use this opportunity to expose a lot of what's really going on in Glasgow around climate change.
What do we want?
Climate justice!
When do we want it?
Now!
Coal was also at the centre of conversation inside the conference, with more than 40 countries vowing to phase it out by mid-century.
The end of coal is in sight.
Developed countries would stop use by 2030 and developing countries by 2040. But some of the biggest users and producers, Australia, the US, Russia, India and China, aren't on board.
I think internationally the expectations of Australia on climate policy are incredibly low. It is isolated, and I think this initiative has isolated it even further.
The federal politics is quite challenging in Australia.
Where are we from the Australian government talking the talk, do you think?
I don't know.
It's easier for some countries than others to stop their use of coal. Here in the UK, there's almost no local production and less than 3% of their energy comes from coal power.
This focus on coal is a pretty convenient way for the UK government to avoid talking about oil and gas production, which is a significant issue for this country. The UK is the second largest oil and gas producer in Europe.
The International Energy Agency says everything promised so far at COP26 would limit global temperature rises to 1.8 degrees Celsius.
To keep 1.5 degrees in reach, we need to go much further and we need to go much faster.
There's still a week left of conference negotiations for the world to agree to clean up its act. Isabella Higgins, ABC News, Glasgow.